Good day, everybody. This will be another computer class tutorial, and that will be the first video on the software which is called Dips. So for this software Dips, we can plot discontinuities if we know dip in dip directions, and also we can analyze them. We can conduct different types of analysis. Typically, we talk about kinematic toppling or planar failure. And that will be my second and third videos. So in this video, I just want to talk about general things and basics, what you need to know, how to draw stereonets, how to draw great circles, and how to draw poles. And what we can do is we just start a new file. So when you start new file, click here new, and you will see this spreadsheet that looks very similar to Excel spreadsheet, and you see here dip in dip direction. Sometimes you may have a different maybe trend or strike or things like that. So what you can do, you can go to analysis, project settings, and here you just make sure that global orientation format you use will be dip in dip direction. So you see you can have a few other options here. This is project summary, so you can write some comments, project title if you want. So we're not gonna do that. Okay, and it's very easy to use this application. So if we perform site investigation and we measure different directions of discontinuities, or even if we get even more information about spacings and things like that, we can put all this information in one file. And the way to do it, you just go to the cells, and for example, for dip, let's say that we have a discontinuity with a dip of 45 degrees and dip direction maybe only 10 degrees. So we plot one, then we have another one which is almost vertical, 89 degrees with a dip direction maybe 235. So, and then let's plot one more. The one is very gentle, like almost horizontal. I'll put 0.2 degrees deep, and deep direction maybe 180. Okay, so what we can do next, we can plot this data. And the way to do it, we just click this button. So it says vector preset. And we click this one. And you will see, this is a stereonet, gives you north, south, east, west, and it also gives you, should be 3 points, okay. Point number one, point number two, and point number three. Remember that we made 2 points, one is very, very gentle, almost horizontal, the other one is vertical. So the one that is vertical is here, the one it's horizontal here. If you still don't know how to read the stereonets and the difference between poles and great circles, watch my videos. I'm gonna put them in the description of this video so that you can find the links easily. So in this case, we plot poles. If we wanna look at planes, which are great circles, we're going here to plot options, and we tick this box. And you see there will be three gray circles that would represent dip and dip directions of those discontinuities. So another good option that we can use is analysis. So if we have lots of data, let me open one of the files that we have in the library. So let's open this one, kinematic analysis toppling, and that will be my second video about this one. You will see that there is lots of data here and lots of points, not only three, so about 300. And it also contains information on spacing, length, type, shape, and surface. So there is some cool option here that we can use. It's a chart, so we're going to analysis, we click chart, and then we can plot any of the data. So we just need to select the column, and let's go with maybe surface, right? Click surface, okay. So in this case, we can look at the summary of five different types of rock surfaces, and we see that out of five, the dominant are rough surface and also smooth surface, right? So at this, we can plot any other data. Another thing, look, if you look at this file, you will see it has lots of columns with the information. And when we just started, where is the file? We have only two columns. So we can always add more columns and more information. So what we'll do, just go to deep direction, which is the furthest on the right, and right click of mouse, add column. And then let's say it will be spacing. Okay. Then maybe we need to add another one, surface. Okay, and then if we have any data, we can just either put it in manually. Sometimes we have data in a Word file or Excel file, we just copy and paste. So that's pretty simple. Okay, so that's it for the basic of this software, Dips. And please watch my next video that will be about kinematic analysis. Bye, everybody.